Hello YouTube, welcome to episode 29 of Storyteller Plays Pokemon Sword. So like what I said I was going to do with episode 28, where I just record, you know, 28 and 29 in one long continuous thing so I can split it in the middle somewhere that makes sense. That's happening now with 29 and 30. I'm starting this here because I'm not entirely sure what happens when I cross this threshold, because if you watched the last episode, I kind of flew away instead of engaging Pierce here. Hey there, buddy. Oh, so I probably could have just walked right past him. Man, why am I here for this? I'm totally exhausted from that battle with you, Satu. We decided that Team Yell will cheer you on, Satu. So, please, let's help out together. Why is that guinea pig not on a leash?
What a beautiful display of sibling love,
Mom.
However, the entire thing is unnecessary.
Miss Oleana?
Jim and Rose is with the champion in a very, very important meeting. There is no way I will let anyone interfere. After all, I only authorized personnel with the proper key can ride the monorail to Rose's tower. That means as long as Chairman Rose is in the tower, no one can disturb him.
Okay, I'm done doing that voice.
I have hand-selected...
okay, I'll stop. I have hand-selected a member of the League staff and given them a key. Chairman Rose does enjoy these kinds of menial games after all. Do you think you can tell the difference between normal League staff and the one I've chosen? Is it the darker sunglasses? Do you think you can find me? Okay, fine. Let's play a game of cat and mouse. What should we do?
This isn't good, but I got this one.
Satu, Team Yell, Team Yell's Yellen will handle this. Team Yell's Yellen will handle this. Okay, that's better. No, this is brilliant. I'll search around the front of the stadium. This is brilliant. I'll search around the front of the stadium. I was recording like half an hour ago, and I've already unable to do the voices. For now, let's try to head to the plaza together, shall we? Yes. I mean, I could walk on my own. All right, let's all work together and head for Rose Tower. We're finally working with the big brother I've never had, Pierce. I've got a little brother. Let's find Oleana's League staff member. The bad one's wearing those lame shades, right? I mean, most of them are wearing some pretty lame glasses. But let's look around for somebody acting all suspect. Hello, you're not wearing lame shades. I mean, yes you are. But your shades aren't excessively lame. I don't suppose it would be the one facing a wall now, would it? Hey, Satu, this bloke's awfully shifty, but I can't get him to turn around. Say something surprising, so he'll have no choice but to look this way. I like Boston baked beans. Hey, Satu, this bloke's looking... Oh, I already said that before. Where do you have the key, you know?
What? Blaster turned around. And I can't escape? In that case, time for a Pokemon battle.
Oh, these episodes are gonna be a mess. Macrocosmos, Eric. Oh no, a Meowth. I actually don't know Meowth's typing. It's probably type normal, so I'm going to use a Dragon Dart, whatever it's called. Go, Dragon Darts. Good thing it's not part fairy, otherwise this wouldn't have worked either. It's not very effective. But Meowth did faint. What is Meowth typing? It's about to send in a Durant. Yeah, I keep battling. Look at the little boy be steel bug type. My cheers will really get you going. Thanks for the help. I'm being a dork. Burhurt's speed rose sharply. Thank you, Burhurt. I'm going to need it. I'm joking, I'm super fast. Burhurt is fast as fuck, boy! Don't suddenly talk to me like that. I accidentally turned around. All I need to do is hide, and I won't have to give you the key.
But we already beat you. Where do you get safety pins that large? I was wondering how fast that guy could run. I've got no idea where he went, Gov. Has anybody seen a strange-looking shifty man? If I remember correctly, he does eventually run into that phone booth. Nope, I heard a horse. Nope, that's not him. Nope, 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 nope. I'm genuinely stumped. I don't suppose you've seen a guy in dorky-looking shades, have you?
How'd you find me? Or did I just talk to everyone you meet? Bah, whatever. I'll defeat you this time.
No, you won't. I don't think you have a chance. Challenged by Macrocosmos Eric. Okay, I was worried my housemate was coming home, because then I would have to stop recording. But he just sent me a picture of an octopus candle holder, which is kind of cool. Uh-oh. That thing's part fairy type, right? Steel fairy, I believe? Shadow Ball will take it down, though, so who cares? And Mawile's down for the count. I'm more than twice her level, though, so of course it was going to happen. Was that Mawile a he? I should probably ask. Exadrill, what are your pronouns? Feel that flow? Yeah, you feeling it, Satu? Let's go! I figure the game can't handle it, but why is Marnie not following me around in the overworld as well? Highly suspect game. How does she keep finding me other than the fact that we're all standing in this one town square? And I even switched up my Pokemon while I was running. Why don't you just get to choose which Pokemon you send out first? They say hide a tree in a forest, so I thought I could hide myself in a crowd. Hear me out, Pokemon. If we have battle mode set to set, at least let us pick the Pokemon we send out first. How cool would that be? Get out of the phone booth. You're way too observant, but I'll win this time and make my getaway. You could have just stayed in the phone booth. Macrocosmos Eric. A Pharaoh Seed? What is that, steel grass? Just steel? Doesn't make too much of a difference. Okay, let's go ahead and use Shadow Ball. Burhurt used Shadow Ball. And the opposing Pharaoh Seed fainted, because of course it did. Honestly, you'd think that these guys would, like, take one look at my Pokemon and go, oh, second thought, maybe you just kind of win. Ooh, that's a big old steel type. Yeah, have some of my support. I know you can keep the beat going. It's like, dance, Pokemon. Dance, Burhurt, I believe in you. Let's just go ahead and use Shadow Ball. If it ain't broken, don't fix it. And Steelix is down for the count. Hiding didn't work, and battles didn't work. Only thing to do now is run. Give me the key first, you prick. Seems like you got me cornered, but I'm not going to give up. An earful from Miss Oleana is way worse than anything you lot can do. Good luck catching me on the monorail. Team Yell, go find Hop. We'll corner the League staff member at the station together. Let's go. Oh, there's more of them with sunglasses. You know, he could have just made a run for it. Why is everybody in this room a mime? You did a cracking job of cornering that bad league staff member, Satu. Let me sing a song fitting of your rockin' deeds. The only thing a humble singer can do is sing a humble song. Maybe I can't cheer someone on just with the tunes I play. Maybe my songs don't make everyone happy. Maybe I can't help. But still, the only thing I can do is sing my humble song.
Pierce! Go, Pierce!
Oh, wait, this banner is Marion. Marion? Marion? I already forgot her name. Marnie? Hey, isn't that Pierce? Why is he doing a street performance in the middle of this station? I think you mean a street a station performance. See, this person gets it, even though I can't read. Come on, let's see if we can get closer. Are those two playing Pokemon Go? Why are there just loose dogs in here? Oh, well, they're headbanging, so, you know, I approve. Now, which one of these guys has the key? We got the key, Pierce! We can take the monorail to Rose Tower now! Pierce is busy. Oh, and Cat's got the zoomies. Satu, hop! Now's your chance! Go, get out of here! Yeah, leave it to the three kids. Although I guess Pierce is a little bit busy. Things are looking fierce. So, this is Rose Tower. So, this is Rose Tower. Just how tall do you think it is? This isn't what he sounded like before. I can't even see the top up there, up in the clouds. All the voices are just merging together now. Become one. So what do you think we should do? Team Yell is going to have their hands full holding up the bad league staff members. They won't be catching up anytime soon. Yay. Satu, what should we do? Let's go ahead. Good thinking. Let's collect Lee and get out of here. Without him, there's no champion for you to challenge in the Champion Cup. Satu, you cleared the way to Rose Tower. Now all you gotta do is charge on ahead. An employee's an employee, I guess. Seems that exec lady hid the monorail key to try to impress the chairman. Chairman Rose been keeping the champion holed up inside. I wonder what he's plotting. Oh well, look who it is. Times like this, when tension and passion run high. This is not what he sounds like. Times like this, when passion and tension run high. Remind me of Spike Muth in the old days. Some right wild concerts we had back then, but no encores. Wait, you're still here? If we weren't still here, who'd you be talking to, my dude? You better get going. I'll send some support your way with the yell. Gotta stick around to make sure my bro doesn't do anything too crazy, right? Come back if you need anything. Let's go, Satu. Pierce, what was that bow? How is your hair not so heavy it just snaps your neck? Yes, we have an appointment. Wow. Yes, we have an appointment. Whoa, it's huge in here. What in the world is this place meant to be? Hop, you're standing on the roses. Now I'm standing on the roses. Is this just a carpet? Why does it look so real? Listen, Satu, I don't know if you knew this already, but I've heard Rose built a tower on a power spot. Yeah, you know what I was saying. Yeah, you know what I'm saying. When we get to the roof, I have a bit of space. We can Dynamax our Pokemon. Which is all well and good, but but less certain is whether this lift can get us to the top. Rose Tower has like 100 floors, right?
You'll be leaving right now, so there's no need to worry about the lift.
Intruder alert! Intruder alert! All staff are ordered to help remove the intruders from the premises at once.
See? If Miss Oleana says so, then it looks like this is the end of the line for you kids. If I get rid of the intruders, I'll probably get a big bonus. No, you won't. A Durant? Why do you all use steel types? Is there like some importance to all of you using steel types that I'm not paying attention to? Because when am I ever paying attention? landed a critical hit. Sleep well, Durant. You wouldn't have survived that anyway, unless you had sturdy. R.I.P. Having to give up my pocket money. Losing means I'm back in the red. Dude, you can just keep the money. Also, how little are they paying you? My bonus. My dream of finally affording a house of my own. We need to speak with Chairman Rose. Tell us where he is. Get on the lift. The chairman's at the top of the building. Wow, turncoat. All right, we're nearly to the Chairman Rose. Hold on, Lee, we're coming. Come on, Satu, let's crack on. Ooh, fancy symbol. Why does this elevator need to be so large? Hopefully, we're not stopped. This has taken ages. Oh wait, I'm giving him the wrong voice. This has taken ages. What? I don't think we're at the roof yet. Why have we stopped? Uh-oh, looks like a double battle. You two are gym challengers, aren't you? Thank you for taking part in the Galar League's gym challenge. Yet, I'm afraid that doesn't give you the right to interfere with our work. We will drive you out to protect the many solid, subsidiary companies housed here in Rose Tower. Behold the glorious high-tech elevators of Rose Tower, able to withstand Pokemon battles. They are constructed by the subsidiary Macrocosmos Construction. Which one of you deals with ghost types? I know one of you does. Okay, hop. I'll take out the one on the left because it's at least maybe psychic type. I genuinely don't know. Go ahead and use Shadow Ball on the one on the left. Even if not, it'll probably KO it. Any Pokemon that doesn't dodge that only has themselves to blame. Did you see how slow it was? A double, I don't think that's going to do much. Yeah, it wasn't very effective. Of course, it is Hop giving the orders, so... Going Burt, Shadow Ball. We've created an extraordinary lift that's safe even for a Pokemon battle. Nobody can beat Macrocosmos Construction when it comes to our dedication to our work. But we can beat you in Pokemon battles. If I've been defeated, I have little choice but to respectfully retreat. Yet I must ask once more that you please do not interfere with Chairman Rose's work. The elevators in Rose Tower are constructed so that only the floor ascends, but that presents some danger, thus the presence of these walls constructed of light. You can thank Macrocosmos Construction for providing this wonderful technology as well. What? Wait, so the folks working in this tower can stop the elevator from the outside at any time? We're just trying to get to the top already. Our teams have worked themselves ragged for us. Let's heal them all up. I am mixing voices. Ah, so these walls of light would prevent me from sticking my head out and decapitating myself on one of these elevator doors. Impressive, Macrocosmos, impressive.
Rose Tower is almost 1,000 feet tall.
You are now 500 feet above the ground. I'm from MC Insurance. Do you have a life insurance policy? Is that a death threat? That sounds like a death threat. But also probably. I'd imagine that parents, smart parents anyway, would take out a life insurance policy on their kids before sending them out on a dangerous adventure like these. I am just gonna skip the fights because there's no way I can lose. So I'll just read the dialogue. Nobody can beat MC Insurance when it comes to our dedication to our work. This building's well over 500 feet tall. You said it was 1,000 earlier. But also, Somebody else said that the construction company is the most dedicated to their work. I'm quite terrified of heights, actually. Unfortunately, our insurance doesn't pay out for being defeated in Pokemon battles. So what you said earlier was a death threat. I feckin' called it. You okay there, Hop? You look bored. You're nearly to the top, but you'll not be able to be meeting the chairman.
I've lost. I've got no fear of heights, unlike the people a couple hundred floors below. I work high in the skies doing my job for the lofty macrocosmos air.
Does that mean you have a fighting type, or is this all for show? I mean flying type. Wow, I'm tired. And the answer is no, for those of you curious at home.
Nobody can beat Macrocosmos Rare when it comes to dedication to our work. They all say the same shit.
You ever get that floaty feeling when the lift is going up? I mostly get that floaty feeling when the lift is going down, actually. Like, my stomach is staying where it is, but the floor below me is moving downwards.
Don't you presume to meet the chairman. You are not on the same level as such a great man. You must know that the high rises, blah, blah, blah. I genuinely don't care about dialogue anymore.
They're just talking way too much and about nothing at all. This place is pretty impressive. I'm going to guess that the glass dome here is pressurized, otherwise we'd explode.
Welcome to Chairman Rose's exclusive space. Here, nearly 1,000 feet above the earth. So, you got through all the special staff that I had ordered to stop you. I would expect nothing less of the trainers handpicked by the champion Leon himself. But I'm afraid it is now time for you to go home. Because I will not allow anyone to disturb the great Chairman Rose. You shall be the first, Satu. If I beat you to pieces, then the champion will have no one to battle and will thus lose heart. In that state, he will listen to anything the chairman says.
Wow, this lady's crazy. Oh no, a ghost type. Ghost ice type, so actually I'm like super weak to the ghost ice type. Not that it bothers me much. Because we have one thing she doesn't. A 50 level lead. Not to mention that Burhurt here is EV trained in speed and special attack. All of my other Pokemon are also EV trained in speed and special attack, but they're not level 100 yet.
My how cheeky do blah 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 blah. I was busy doing other things.
Salazzle? No, don't need to switch my Pokemon. Although I could have sent out Earl Grey. Let's go ahead and use Shadow Ball. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. He's about to send in Serena. Keep battling. I'm however going to mix things up a bit by using Dragon Pulse. With my 50 level lead, it doesn't make too much of a difference. And Serena's down.
Rest in peace.
Milotic, will you switch Pokemon? I actually will. Oh. I said I'm not going to. Well, that's what I get for being stupid, I suppose. Let's go and use Shadow Ball. I think this one's Fairy type. Is it not Fairy type? Who's paying attention? Certainly not me. R.I.P. Milotic. R.I.P. Who are you sending out? Garbodor? I will switch Pokemon. To Shedinja.
This is my last Pokemon, seriously. Oleana's gotta finish this.
Oh, she's speaking about herself in the third person now.
Oh no, a Garbodor. I hope it's not Gigantamax Garbodor. Let's see which is most powerful. I believe Shedinja has higher special than physical. I don't know, let's find out. Oh no, she also has a Pokemon. A Gigantamax at Rose Tower. Oh no, I called it. It's like I've played this game before. One moment, I have to respond to something. One moment, I was typing. What happened? Did it faint? Way to go, Shedinja! Shedinja's a baby.
Say, I wasn't able to win, Oleana. You really are a hopeless woman.
Urgh, this is inexcusable. What was I thinking? Any gym leader who's made it this far would be no pushover. Under normal circumstances, I would have tried to delay you further. However, all necessary wishing stars have been collected. Do as you wish. There is nothing to be done now.
I decided, like, halfway through the fight that she was going to sound like that now.
Typical Satu. You and Dragapult are unstoppable.
Everything I did to further the chairman's own goals.
King Candy, that's what that sounds like. But like a bad King Candy.
Leon, we've discussed this 100 times already, and you still fail to understand what's at stake? You, who's supposed to be our champion?
I think I understand well enough. What I don't understand is why we ought to cancel tomorrow's tournament in order to solve a problem that's 1,000 years away from affecting any of us. What difference is one day going to make? My duty as champion isn't this. This madness. It's to carry out that championship match. That's what Galar wants, and that's what I want. It's what we all have been looking forward to for so long.
No, you don't understand. You still don't understand a thing. Look around us, Leon. Look at the Galar region stretched out before us. And know that the energy required to keep this brilliant, glittering world alive will be exhausted 1 millennium from now. The people of Galar today will no longer even exist. What Galar wants today hardly matters. The future is more important than just one day. We must act as quickly as we possibly can. We must take action in order to avert tragedy so that all can look forward to a better future.
In 1,000 years? Fine, look, I think I understand your concerns, Chairman, and I give my word I'll help you with your plans just as soon as tomorrow's match is over.
Lee!
You never show up when you're you never showed up when you were supposed to, so I got worried that something might have happened. Pierce and Marnie and all those Team Yellow oddballs, they all helped us get here.
I must apologize to you, Hop, if we've made you worry at all. There are times when adults just can't seem to have an honest discussion with one another. Sometimes our pride just gets in the way.
Never mind any of this, Hop, Satu. Let's head back to the hotel, and we'll all grab dinner tonight, yeah? It's on me, so you can order whatever you fancy.
I am going to order the lobster.
If you'll excuse us, Chairman Rose. And I do hope you'll watch tomorrow's match. It sure is to be one for the history books.
I should have showed up dressed as Chairman Rose. It was an option.
One for the history books.
You still don't understand, young champion. We, no, I am going to change the course of history.
The next evening!
So realistic. Everyone's got their phones out all the time.
This is it. Did you get enough sleep? You and your team are the ones battling, but I've had Butterfree in my stomach since I woke up.
Challenger Satu, the finals will be starting shortly. I'm here to escort you to the stadium.
What's all this? Didn't learn your lesson yesterday. If you need another helping of Hop and his trusty Rillaboom that you never actually fucking used, I'll be happy to give you one. No, wait, please. I'm not one of those other league staff. I'm a good one, if I may say so myself. See, my glasses aren't dark-tinted. Miss Oleana can be a little extreme, that's an understatement, in her desire to assist the chairman with his goals, I'm afraid. It seems she was cultivating her own group of league staff in secret to be deployed for, well, things that... like that debacle last night. But you've no one to worry about. You've no need to worry about today's staff. All of us are here for the right reasons. Well, that's what she says. I guess we trust her then, yes, Atu? Let's head. I can't wait another minute. Would you like me to show you the way to the Windun Stadium? No, I do not. I have stuff I need to do real quick, just checking. If I don't find it, I'll cut back to here, obviously. Oh, well, never mind. This isn't even the right hotel. Bye. I probably should have just let her escort me, because now I gotta walk all the way over there, and it's gonna be a pain, and you know how it is. Did you know there was a tube just outside of the hotel I could have used? That's not the one I used, but it's there. Say it too! This is it. Here we are. Here at Windun Stadium, the greatest stadium in all of Galar. You're going to show everyone the greatest battle ever, mate, and set the world on fire. Listen, Hop, I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a fire in my heart. Go get yourself checked in. Let me hop on my bike. Just to immediately hop back off of it. Ball guy! Excuse me, ladies. Hi there! Thanks for rolling by to have a chat with your mate, the ball guy. I can tell you are following your dreams, and that means, you guessed it, I've got a Pokeball for you. A dream ball? Thank you. A somewhat different Pokeball that makes it easier to catch Pokemon while they're asleep. Pokemon that are asleep are easy to catch, but did you ever want it to be even easier? Well, the Dream Ball will make your dreams come true. Have your Pokemon use Hypnosis or Yawn to put the Pokemon to sleep and give it a try. Pokeballs are just full of surprises, don't you think? Look at all these people cheering for me. Challenger Satu, we've been waiting for you. Why did you not get escorted here? Since you won your way through the semifinals, you must face off against the gym leaders in the finals, and they won't be holding back. Whoever makes it through the final bracket will win the right to challenge the champion. So, are you ready to go to the locker room now?
Yep.
Then I'll show you the way. But if none of the gym leaders can become champion, why are they all here? Like, I understand just to test me, but like, what happens if they win? Ryan, how big are you?
I'm going to win my way through every round. Then, I'll be the one taking on Leon. If I don't, then he'll have failed to repay Durdleron and the rest of my team for all their hard work.
It's a curious feeling. My heart is racing a bit, but I still can't wait for the match to begin.
I'm not going to talk to all these people because I don't remember any of their voices. May I go through and purchase myself a candy bar? I'm absolutely famished. Fine. Well, that board has nothing on it. Let's go.
Will you be heading onto the pitch? The opening ceremony should be starting soon. Let's go.
This is going to be a long episode. It probably goes without saying, but hello, Galar. I'm your champion, Leon. The chairman is tied up with some business, so I have no one minds something. I'm not going to read all this. I thought I set speed to normal. Why is it going by so fast? Till the greatest challenger remains. On behalf of the chairman, allow me to say, let the semifinal matches begin. Semifinals were yesterday.
Wait, you?
Bidet, you look different.
Who's that?
Who's that Pokemon?
It's Bead. I mean Bidet.
A moment, if I may. Does anyone here even remember me? I am Bead, the challenger who was forced to withdraw from the gym challenge.
Bidet, he's the challenger endorsed by the Chairman Rose himself.
I keep reading the Chairman Rose. I have a score to settle with Challenger Satu here. I'm aware that this is against the rules, but I must ask nonetheless. Let me battle them. I'll stake my career as challenger on this battle. If I lose, I'll retire from being a trainer.
What an unexpected turn of events. Former challenger Bidet has come for one last battle.
We are currently debating what to do with Challenger Bidet. To all of our viewers, both here in the stadium and at home in front of the telly, we ask that you please be patient.
I know this sounds ridiculous of me, but I had to say something. Do something. Ever since you showed me up, everything I've done has gone wrong. It was Oleana who asked me to gather wishing stars for the chairman, but then the chairman himself disowned me. And then that strange old lady comes out of nowhere and drags me into the boot camp on fairy type Pokemon. Do you have any idea what I've been through, covered in pink, dealing with quizzes and battles with fairy type Pokemon every day? And here I am, pouring my heart out to you, when I've never lost my cool before. We've reached a decision, ladies and gentlemen. The champion himself has accepted Bidet's sudden interruption. Is the champion showing his love by giving every trainer a chance to grow stronger? Or is it a trial for Challenger Satu? My will hasn't been broken yet. Okay, Bidet, let's do this shit. By challenger, your gym leader, Bidet. Sent out Mawile. That thing's steel fairy type, right? I'm joking, I know Mawile's type. I made that joke last episode. Was it earlier this episode? I don't know, it's been about 40 minutes. We've faced too much to quit now. We've got no choice but to win. Oh no, Mawile's Intimidate didn't do shit. Let's go ahead and use Shadow Ball. Dragon-type moves are not effective after all. Eat purple. It's about to send in Gardevoir. Nope, keep battling. I'm sorry, Bidet, but you're kind of SOL. I refuse to lose. Nice outfit, by the way. I'm trying to figure out if your shirt is, like, just really long and you have it tied behind your back. Is that, like, a scarf? Not a scarf, but, like, a belt-type thing that matches your dress? I mean, shirt? What's going on here, Bidet? Give me answers. I need answers. Rapidash? No, I'll keep battling. I guess half of his Pokemon were already fairy-type anyway. Let's go ahead and just use Shadow Ball again, because, I don't know. It works. It just works. Tis super effective. I know you can do it, Burhurt. It's about to send in Hatrin. Will you switch your Pokemon? No. What's with the calm expression? You think you're going to win? I'm pretty sure I'm going to win, my dude. Well, if it isn't, a G-Max Hatrin. Oh, Hatrin shuddered. And Shadow Ball again. We'll show you a truly giant, truly great pink. That's all I could read, because I'm being stupid. Oh no, Bidet is Gigantamaxing. So what is Hatterin? Is it like some kind of a stick figure inside of all that weird hair? Oh well, it doesn't matter. It's dead. D-E-A-D.
I couldn't win, but at least I was able to show everyone how great fairy types are. Opal probably could have done that too. I happen to know she's not dead. Well, I lost. It looks like the challenger Bidet has no match, was no match for challenger Satu and his their trusted team. Quit misgendering me, game. Come on. When is the Pokemon game where you actually get to pick your pronouns going to come out? Hey, Bidet, that was some match. Don't retire. Just restart your career. Pick a Pokemon type that doesn't suck. But this isn't what I planned. If I was able to defeat you, then everything would be just fine. Even if I lost, I was going to use retiring as an excuse to get away from that old lady. You just keep messing up my plans. With everyone cheering me on like this, I have no choice but to continue my training as the fairy-type gym leader. Though, I suppose with my talent, I'll be able to overtake Miss Opal in no time. The stadium is filled with voices cheering on these two young trainers. Now, Challenger Satu, please head back to the locker room so that you can rest up from that unexpected match.
Rather surprising for Challenger Bidet to burge in like that. In any case, once you're ready, please head onto the pitch. The finals are about to begin for real this time.
Where is everybody? Am I alone? Is this purgatory? No, okay, let's go. The time for waiting is over. The finals of the Champion Cup are about to begin. The two trainers to face each other in this first battle round are... a trainer endorsed by the champion himself, Challenger Satu! Their opponent is... the Raging Wave, the Master of Water Types, Nesso!
I can tell you've grown far stronger since you faced me in Holberry Stadium. I've got to hand it to our undefeated champion... he's got a proper eye for talent, too. But you're not the champion, and you'll never become the champion either. Do you know why? It's because I, Nessa, am going to defeat both you and Leon. I'm not going to underestimate you again. I'll use Dynamax to wash you and wash you out to sea and beyond the horizon.
Yeah, but what happens if you win? Because gym leaders can't become champion unless you've got somebody already, like, set up to take over for you. You are challenged by gym leader Nessa. Oh no, it's Galipasabar. Galipasabar. Are you excited, Herbert? I mean, Berhert. I can't read. Well, actually, reading is the problem here.
Sonia might be disappointed, but I'm going to wash your team away.
Eh, who cares what Sonia thinks? Go ahead and Shadow Ball. It's the only string to my bow, after all.
It's super effective.
Well, it wasn't, but it 1-8 KO'd Galipasabar anyway, because I'm overleveled.
OP as hell.
He's about to send in Barrascuda. Nope, just keep battling. Doesn't matter that it's water ground type. That's not what I was thinking it was. I don't know that's typing, actually. Oh, well, nothing a little Shadow Ball can't fix. And it's a one-hit KO. Almost said it was super effective again, but it wasn't. I need to stop saying things.
All of it just say stuff and pretend it's true.
Pelipper? Yes, I'll switch Pokemon. To not Pichu. Go out there, not Pichu. I believe in you. Pelipper, nobody saw it coming. Too bad not Pichu doesn't know Thunder, because that would have actually been a pretty cool power play. But I'm super fast, so go ahead and use Electro Ball. And Pelipper's down for the count. Y'all are doing so great. I'm so proud of you. He's about to send in Sea King. Will you switch your Pokemon? Yes. To Shedinja. Thought it would send out an actually good Pokemon. What kind of attitude is that? Shedinja is great. I'm going to Dynamax and kill everybody behind me. Let's go ahead and use Max Phantasm. You know, my character would look much cooler if the game would let me pick what I wear. But no, I've got to wear the regular Challenger uniform. And if you read Shedinja's Pokedex entry, you would know that everybody who can see that hole on its back, including us, will have their soul ripped out. So RIP everyone, I suppose. My team is so powerful. Why would I switch out Pokemon? Looks like I'm down to the last Pokemon. I've been saving the best for last. Go Dredner. Yeah, I know how this works. You're going to G-Max it. Blah, 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 blah. Shedinja, Max Phantasm. Flood the stadium and take it to our ocean. That's not what she said. Still, flooding the stadium is a bad idea. Do you think that's a temporary tattoo, or did she get that thing permanently tattooed onto her? Because if she ever becomes not the gym leader, that thing's gonna look really tacky. I like that the audience cheers. It's like this is a real SoCar game. Oh, Dreadnought survived. Let's hope it doesn't know any Dark-type moves. Max Darkness! Oh no! Shedinja! That probably sounded horrible. I have no choice but to surrender. Or do I? Go Earl Grey. Actually, I'm gonna send out Phalia. Last time I sent Phalia out, she didn't actually get to do anything. Well, she did, but that's not the point. Let's go ahead and use Hydro Pump. Using a full restore, coward. Hydro Pump is probably not gonna one-hit KO it, so I don't know what you're doing here. Oh, it one-hit KO'd it. Actually, I had a feeling it would. R.I.P. Giant Dreadnought. Oh, dead ball guy's dead. Did you see that? Dead ball guy. Oh, Earl Grey leveled up. I think I'm losing my mind a tiny bit more as I record. You had no problem at all handling our surging might. It's no wonder that you won. And the winner is... Satu! They defeated Nessa during the gym challenge, and now has pulled it off again. You and your Pokémon are just too much. Even with my Dynamaxed partner, Gigantamaxed even, you weathered our waves and stood firm. Now that I think about it, Sonya was saying something about how amazing you were. I wish I'd paid more attention to what she was talking about. I bet everyone in Galar's got their eyes on you now. You defeated my team, so now you've got to ride that current all the way to the end. Now don't go anywhere, ladies and gentlemen. The second battle of the first round will begin shortly. I am moving on, so is B, R.I.P.B., and Piers and Ryan. Let's give Shedinja a tiny bit more love. And continue the fight. Am I to believe that all of these fights took place simultaneously, or... There's like only the one stadium. Ladies and gentlemen, we're already at the second match of the finals. Of the four remaining challengers, which two will be left for the last match? If you're just tuning in, ladies and gentlemen, we witnessed quite the surprise during the finals here at this year's Champion Cup as the former gym challenger Bidet stormed the stage, but Satu was having none of it. This year's top challenger made quick work of him before washing away gym leader Nessa. On the other side, we have the Galar Karate Prodigy. Let's hear it for the gym leader B, everybody. I promise my attacks will shake your very soul this time. May the best trainer win. Yep, may the best trainer win. It is me, I'm the best trainer. Ghost's strongest Pokemon type. Let's ignore that they have many weaknesses, including ghost. Ah, you sent out a bird. If I do not one-hit KO it, things will look bad for me. You might have one win on me, but this is where I show you I can whatever. I didn't read it. Let's go ahead and use Shadow Ball. One Sucker Punch, and I'm kind of SOL. And Sucker Punch sounds like something that a fighting-type gym leader would know. Surfetched. Keep battling. That's another bird. Shadow Ball again. It's the only move I've used. And it's the only move I have to use. Actually, I used Hydro Pump last battle, so... Oh, it held on. And it used a Dark-type move. Rest in peace, Shedinja. You are the hero we needed. I'll just send out Earl Grey. I will not repeat my mistake, whatever that was. I can't remember it, so I'll probably repeat it. But that's not the point. Go ahead and use Psychic. She's going to use a full restore. I know how these matches work. It's super effective. And Sirfetch'd fainted. It's about to send in Phalanx. Will you switch your Pokemon? No. Yep, yeah, go ahead and just use Psychic again. Actually, at this point, I've been talking for like 4 hours. So I think I'm going to go back on my word again. And then end the episode after this, not this match, but the next match. And then record something else. Were you sending out? I wasn't paying that much attention. Ah, Grapplocked. Let's go ahead and just use Psychic. I mean, it's the only thing we've got. The episode will be out well before this does, but I'm actually going to record a game made by a friend of mine, or an acquaintance, or somebody I know. So that's gonna be fun. Keep battling. The time is to dig in our heels, blah 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 blah. I'm not giving up, neither are you. Let's go. Who uses Ultra Balls? Oh well, if she's going to Gigantamax, we're going to Dynamax.
I don't usually.
Ow, my arm. Things are looking great. Let's just destroy everything. Yeah, it's not a good idea. I'd imagine this stadium was pretty expensive to build. This episode is going to be so long. Watch episode 30 end up being significantly shorter by comparison. It won't be, because a lot happens in episode 30. I mean, a lot. Which is why it's probably best I record it on Thursday, when I will also have the house to myself for several hours. Come at it with renewed energy and vigor. I'm just rambling about other stuff now. Oh, would you look at that? Machamp fainted. And the crowd went wild. Because of course they did. Take that, gym leader B. Your strength nearly made me want to turn and run in my bare feet. Yeah, why don't you put on shoes? Assuming this isn't real grass, I can't imagine it feels very good on the old soles of the feet. B has been defeated. Challenger Satu has shown their skill. Thank you for a wonderful match. I really enjoyed battling you and your team. I'm upset that I lost. Very different than what I said. But I also feel so satisfied and so refreshed. In a way, I guess you could say it was the best sort of match anyone could have ever hoped for. I hope that you'll meet many more trainers and have many more matches in the future. And I hope that every one of those encounters will nourish your spirit. Oh, I get it. Spirit, because all of my Pokemon are ghost types. I'm going to steal that pun if I ever become a ghost type gym leader. And it looks like my match is against Ryan. His name is Ryan, right? Sis, you shouldn't be forcing your way in here. Sorry, Satu. I thought my bro could get revenge for me, but he lost to Ryan. You looked so sloppy out there that people are gonna think we're both weak because we're related. You got it wrong, sis. Ryan's just that strong. But I was able to show everyone in the audience how amazing a proper battle without using Dynamax can be. Alright, I get it, but that's exactly what I wanted to win. I still thought it was a brilliant battle, though. I'm counting on you, Satu. Got that? I'm counting on you to win, Satu. Got that? I'll be cheering for you. Sorry to come in here for a chinwag just before the final match. Ryan's waiting for you on the pitch. We're looking forward to a right good battle. Don't worry, Pierce. I won't Dynamax, only to show Ryan that it can be done. Also, my Pokemon are significantly higher level than his. Oh, shit. I mean, shoot. Shedinja is still the head of my party. Oh, I can still change that. Let's go, Burhurt. Let's be the strongest dragons we can be.
Here it is, the last match of the finals. Who will win the right to challenge the unbeatable champion, Leon? Will it be the brilliant rising star, Challenger Satu, or will it be the only trainer that champion Leon calls his rival? The tamer of dragons, Ryan!
What do you mean that's not how it's pronounced?
You're really something else, kid. You've made it all the way here. I guess that's why the champion himself endorsed you, yeah? Leon's my rival, and he's chosen you. So, I've got to first prove I'm better than you if I'm going to beat him. I've reworked my whole team, and now we're all geared up for one-on-one battles. You might be thinking that you beat me once already. But if you think I'm the same Ryan you faced during the gym challenge, you'll soon regret it.
I've sped his voice up because A, it was stupid earlier, and B, we're on a time limit. I've been recording for an hour. This episode is an hour and 44 minutes long. An hour and 44 seconds long, sorry. Also, I'm going to cut a bunch of that out. You're challenged by Gym Leader Ryan. Gym Leader Ryan sent out Torkoal. Come on, Burhurt, I know you can do it. Okay, Burhurt, let's not let him use a sand stream or whatever the hell he's planning to do out here. Well, he just changed the weather to sunny, so I can't imagine he's going to want to kick up a sandstorm. That's drought. It gets the sunlight burning real harsh. Okay, so he plans on using sandstorm later, but let's not let him. It's a one-hit KO. I was about to say, hopefully this Torkoal doesn't have Sturdy, but it just used its ability Drought, so I don't know what I'm on. I'm just stupid. What are you singing out, Turtonator? Smart move, another fire dragon type. But can it withstand the ultimate power that is Dragon Pulse? I don't believe so. Come on, Burhurt, prove me right. And Turtonator is down for the count. Sleep well, Turtonator. Ryan is about to send in Flygon. Will you switch your Pokemon? No, I will not. Okay, so this Flygon is looking pretty intimidating. Let's just go ahead and use Shadow Ball. No need to use super effective moves all the time. I'm nearly 50 levels higher. The opposing Flygon fainted. I don't know why anybody would bother watching these when I'm so overpowered. But that's half the fun. Do you know how much work it took me to get this overpowered? Not a lot, I know several exploits. I mean, it was a lot of hard work, dedication. Just genuine can-do attitude. Take this weird slug creature. Oh, it survived. What exactly are you hoping for Raindance to achieve? I don't know what your plan here is. Here comes the rain. It feels, it's cold dampness. I missed what he said. It's probably something stupid, though. Because, like, what is his strategy here? I know Raihan's shtick is that he changes the weather. But why? Let's just finish it off with a bite. Bite the goo. The opposing Gudra painted. Sleep well, goo. Is about to send in Durladurn. Nope, let's keep battling. Do you realize I'm the great Raihan, right? I'm the one who beat Leon. I don't know. Like I said, I've been recording this episode for an hour. I've been recording completely for the last 2.5, 4. Let's just use Dragon Pulse. We're not going to Dynamax, because we're going to show Piers how it's done. Are you planning on sending everyone in the stadium flying? Why? Why would you do that?
What is the goal here?
Come on. That's a one-hit KO. But of course it was going to be. Was there ever any doubt? I love how epic it is, and then it's just like, and it's dead. Take that, Raihan. Losing in the finals is pretty rough, but I suppose I'd better take a quick snapshot to remember it by. Challenger Satu seizes victory. My lovely Pokemon and I have become much stronger than we were before, but you just blew right past us, beyond anything I'd imagined. I'm still pretty young myself, but it goes to show that there's always someone younger coming up, reaching further than you ever dreamed. And you've got your whole future ahead of you. I'm 25 and I'm wasting most of my life playing video games on the internet. I mean, no, because like I've only been doing this for 8 years and I've been alive for 25, so that's... Never mind, you get the point. Keep up the momentum. Prove that Leon's not unbeatable. Oh, I'm going to. Number 429, Challenger Satu, has achieved a dazzling triumph. The trainer who was endorsed by the champion will now face the very man who endorsed them. The championship match. Alright, the big moment's finally here, eh? Why is your Pokemon allowed out of the Pokeball? Am I the only one who's not allowed to walk around with my Pokemon? What's up with that? I came here to cheer you on, you know. Still, it's not easy picking sides. After all, it's a showdown between my big brother and my rival. Who should I really want to win more? Rillaboom! Right, you reckon I should cheer for Satu too, don't you? Couldn't agree more. After all, we did start this thing out together way back in Postwick. So you better beat Lee, you hear? If anyone can beat the unbeatable champion, it'll be you, mate. Rillaboom! Farewell. I can do this. Let's go! You can't ride your bicycle right now, but it's how I get around dramatically. Was it more stupid than dramatic? It's probably more stupid than dramatic. But here we are, it's the fight everyone's been waiting for. And finally, somebody actually already standing out on the field when I was told they were. Usually they walk out from the side even though I'm told they were already out on the pitch. Do you know how annoying it is to be lied to so constantly? The tense still air on the pitch. And the exact opposite from the audience, cheering and yelling. They're both fantastic, wouldn't you say? But remember, the audience is also a bit cruel, so they want nothing more than to see one of us lose, after all. It can fill you with the fear knowing that, but I absolutely love pushing past the fear. I love giving it everything I've got as a trainer, and seeing my team give everything they've got to seize another victory. This is the greatest feeling in the world, and I can't get enough of it. I can feel my partners itching with anticipation inside their Pokeballs. Where do you keep your Pokeballs? Where do I keep my Pokeballs? We're going to have a real champion time. I'm the Galar region's champion, Leon. Me and Charizard and all the rest of our team will use all our knowledge and experience to crush you properly. Is everybody ready for the match we've all been waiting for? Wait, hold on.
Hey, look at the monitor.
What's that on the big screen? At the point of you saying something? Nothing. Nothing's on the big screen.
Hello there, Leon and Satu. Just letting you know.
I think it's time I brought about the darkest day for the sake of Gala's future, of course. But I'm in a bit of a pickle. The energy released by the darkest day is too much for us to contain. That could have killed one of us. Why couldn't it have killed me? Please. I've been good this year. I'm sorry to come to this, but whatever. Leon, you refuse to listen. Everybody off the field.
Lee! Satu! That video stream. That was from Hammerlock Stadium, right? What in the world did the chairman do? I don't know. But everything he was saying yesterday, did he really pull all this crazy stunt to solve some problem 1,000 years in the future? I've got to see what's going on. I'm the champion. I've got to go. I should have realized this is what the chairman intended to do before it came to this. I'll take responsibility now for fixing this mess. This is the champion. This is the real champion time. I'm going to assume that Rose didn't have any cameras. So he knew I would be the one out on the field. But Lee, you're terrible at directions. What if you get lost along the way? I want to help my brother, Satu. I've got to go too. But I can't even manage to beat you, so what sort of help will I ever be? Just try, my dude. But what? What can I even do? Hold the phone. The chairman was talking about the darkest day. That's the thing where the sky went all dark once, ages and ages ago, right? About 1,000 years. What does he mean? He's bringing that about? And where did we even hear that name? Back in Motostoke. The Statue of the Hero in Motostoke. Sonia said something about it back then, didn't she? Though, it turned out to be wrong, since there were actually two heroes and all that. Still, those two managed to bring an end to the darkest day with the Sword and the Shield Pokemon. Sonia thought the Pokemon might still be sleeping somewhere, though, right? Maybe in the Slumbering Weld? If I was gonna slumber, I'd slumber in the Slumbering Weld. Maybe even Weld, I don't fucking know. We should try to find them, Satu. But where to start looking? Back in the Slumbering Weld? That's it, Satu. I'm sure it's going to be in Slumbering Weld. That illusion you tried to fight off that day, it must have been one of the Pokemon that are supposed to be sleeping there. Slumbering there, Hop. Let's get back to the Slumbering Weld. If we're lucky, we'll find something that can help. We've got this. Ah, home sweet home. Sonia, get out from in front of my house. Huh? Satu? Hop? Oh, I completely forgot about the championship match. What are you two doing here? Not the champion match, that's what's up.
Haven't you been watching the news and all that? The tournament is off, Sonia. The chairman saw to that, and sending the entire region into a state of havoc.
That's not what she sounded like before. Huh? What? What happened while I was researching things in the Slumbering Weald?
Well, for starters, there's a great black storm or something raging over Hammerlock Stadium.
What are they calling it?
The darkest day? It's thrown everything into disarray.
Still, I'm sure we don't need to worry too much. The unbeatable champion will be able to take care of everything, won't he? Hold on a tick, ma'am. Did you say the darkest day? The darkest day is the name for the black storm that nearly brought the Galar region to ruin in ancient times. So, what are you here for, Satu? I'm here to stop the darkest day. I'm like, what else? To stop the darkest day? You mean you're going to search for the Sword and Shield Pokemon? Okay, here, take this. You should head into the Slumbering Weld. I'll catch up with you once I'm done looking into something that's been bothering me. I don't need these. I'm going to use them all on Shedinja. Restore Shedinja to full health and all that.
All that matters is that you do what you can. You've become a fine Pokemon trainer, after all.
I'm so proud. My mom believes in me.
Can we stop with the dialogue so I can end this episode? Ready for this, Satu?
I wonder if we're about to head straight into a wall of fog again. Not that it'd bother us now. We've both grown loads stronger, and so have our Pokemon. Going into the forest after Wulu that day, that was the start of everything, wasn't it? A legendary beginning, really. I reckon whatever we're about to see will be pretty legendary itself. Let's head in and add another page to our tale. Let's. In episode 30, I know I said I was going to record episode 29 and 30 all in one go, but I've been recording for an hour and 13 minutes now. I need to rest my voice, probably eat some food, and then record something else, so prepare for episode 30 to be an hour long as well. But later. Peace.